The only dead fae we know about is, or fae's, is Mia and Army, who's the original fae. I think Pearls picked this up. She mentioned that she was trying to do a channeling. I don't know. It tells us lots of information, but I need to piece it together with questions.
I better give it a good looking over and some serious thought. Make sure you chuck it in the trash when you're done. Later in's a cry, pal.
Gumshoe, you're an idiot.
So what do you know about the real murder weapon so far? Well, it wasn't the shishester that was found impaled in the victim's body. Mr. Edgeworth proved that in court today.
Yes, that's true.
In which case, must have been another blade. That's what you're running around like a headless chicken looking for now, huh? Yeah, and man is it tiring work. But let me tell you something, pal. I'm no chicken. We got the favorite forensics in our camp these days. We're using the department's secret weapon on this.
Secret weapon?
Is it gonna be that dog missile?
Please say it is.
What's this secret weapon of yours?
You wanna know? You've got to fix scientifically, okay?
Please! Tell me it's gonna be... what's the name? Emma Sky. It is Emma Sky, isn't it?
Alright. The murder weapon was a sword. Swords are scientifically speaking made of metal, right?
Oh, metal detector.
Any questions so far?
No?
I know what he's gonna say, but I'll let him look smart. So what's the perfect tool for the job? Ta-da! A metal detector!
Oh.
Raise your hand if you didn't see this coming from a mile away. Well, you want to give a scientific investigation a go?
Me?
I've been using this thing for hours now. Gets pretty boring after a while. But you give it a try.
I don't know. Shall Detective Gumshroud or not?
Yeah, sure. Anything we dig up might be useful.
Come on, pal. It's good fun, I'm telling you.
Alright then, I guess I'll give it a go.
Like I said, this is the department's most advanced gadget. The absolute best. So say if you can make it cry. So I take you could skydive off it.
Oh, Bob. Suddenly, Winnie the Pooh comes on the scene. Oh, Bob.
So now I'm going to tell you how to use it. It's possible the real murder weapon is around here somewhere, right?
Sure, that's what we're trying to find out.
Right. So first, let's turn the detector on. That's the sound of the metal detector signal bouncing off of something metallic. Next, touch the detector and take a real good look around this courtyard with it, pal. Once it hits something metallic, the check gauge will flash. When that happens, touch a gauge to really give the area a good search. This thing picks up metallic objects that are hidden from sight too. Take a good look at anything and everything that seems suspicious, okay, pal?
I apologize if this is going to seem a bit annoying. There you go, there's something here.
This is Mr. Oaksnim's staff, isn't it? Scientifically speaking, they're usually made of wood.
Well, the tender is reacting to it.
Yeah, but whatever you look at it, the thing's made of wood, alright? I don't bother investigating anything unless it looks like it might be metallic.
Isn't the whole point of a metal detector to find metal where you can't see it?
It's weird that this thing is causing a racket. Here, let me take a look at it. Hey, hands off! Examine evidence is a job for the... The thumb is coming off! Look what you've done! You've damaged a really important piece of evidence!
Oh shit! Oh my god, Misty Faye was ready to cut a bitch!
It's a sword! A sword? Inside the staff? Is this... Could it be... The murder weapon? I never have guessed there'd be a sword concealed in the victim's staff. The coolest kind of thing a sword came, pal. This one's a real gem. The workmanship is really something else.
It looks like that sword from World of Warcraft that the King of Stormwind's got. Apologies, I'm not very good with names.
Thank goodness it wasn't a cane sword, or else the victim would have stabbed her own foot. I officially give up on trying to figure out how Gumshoe's mind works. If the real scene of a crime was the Inner Temple Garden, then why was the sword used to kill the victim found in the main hall courtyard? Hey Gumshoe, who knows about the hidden sword?
No one. Even police didn't know about this until I discovered it just now.
Right, okay, so I think we'll want to keep that quiet in case whoever's done this slips up.
Well, as they say, there's no team in Gumshoe. Doesn't look like there are any traces of blood on it. Then I guess this isn't a murder weapon, huh? No, no, no. I'm sure someone just wiped it off after the murder. Yeah, of course. This thing's totally the murder weapon. Great job, pal.
How is Gumshoe a really good detective? I think he's used to having Edgeworth with him all the time, isn't he?
It's about the same length as the Shishisto too. This must be the murder weapon. Okay, I'm gonna run over to forensics. There's gotta be some traces of blood left, even if most of it's been wiped off. See you later, pal. Every case is gonna be airtight,
get lost, Gumshoe.
Wait up, detective. What is it, pal?
I'm pretty busy guy right now, you know.
You're gonna get that stuff analysed, right? Do you mind holding off for just a while?
What are you talking about, pal?
Please. Just until we find Maya.
Maya? What's this got to do here?
I don't know, but I'm starting to get a really bad feeling in the pit of my stomach.
Oh? How so?
Look, Maya's trapped inside the sacred cavern right now and... Well, we don't even know if she's okay or not. The more evidence and testimony I hear, the more uneasy I feel.
You don't think...
Maya's been murdered. Please, detective. Let's just wait until we can get inside the secret cavern.
You're looking kind of iridium there.
Okay, okay. Just stop with that face, pal.
One thing, though. This staff's secret trick. Just keep it between you and me, alright? If it gets out of it, we knew about it and didn't say anything, we're finished.
I understand. This is just a regular run-of-the-mill staff, you got it?
Okay, now you take good care of it, pal.
Thank you, detective.
Don't worry, she'll be fine.
Gumshoe. You know, there's a place at the base of this mountain that has some really good pasture.
How about I take you there when you find Maya, her pal?
Sure,
thanks.
I'll be bloody paying for it.
I can't help but wonder though, what was at least Yokesnim doing with stuff like this in the first place?
Protection, I'd imagine. Right, let me just present Godo.
That guy's got more mysteries than a choose your own escapade book, pal.
Yeah, I know, trust me. Can't believe he skipped the trial like that without even getting permission. It'd have been fine for sure if he went for a normal company.
You know where he is now.
Nah, but I bet he's walking around somewhere with a mug of coffee in one hand.
I should have figured. It's like Gumshoe doesn't know about Godo's physical condition.
Of course, being extradited from hell is a tedious affair. The meticulous regeneration and adjustment of all your internal organs is... Well, it's just say modern medicine allows us all to live to ripe old age. Even someone like me.
I had a good reason for missing the trial, so why didn't he tell anyone about it?
Right, okay. So, while I've got some evidence of that stuff, I don't think I've got enough to break bikinis. I don't think I've got enough to break either of the Psyculox. I'm just going to go back to the... Not the courtyard. I'm just going to go back to the garden. Because I know that I've got a bit more to get out of Edgerith, don't I? At least I think I do. I shall go give it a look. Temple gate, and we'll head into the garden. I'd like to tell Edgerith about this, but I don't know if he's a stickler for the rules. Right, okay. Let me just present this to him. I know it's got to be a secret, but it's pretty shiny. Actually, maybe this will...
What do you think about this, Edgerith?
Sorry, right? You're a defense attorney. I'm a prosecutor. Wouldn't be right for us to discuss things so intimately. Okay, this is probably not going to come off, but... Victim staff. Yeah, okay. And the only other piece of evidence that we really got was... Dahlia Hawthorne, question mark.
Oh, there we go. I see. Hey, Edgerith. Did you know that Iris had a twin sister?
What? A twin? You can't be serious.
Sister Bikini told me, but... The problem is she didn't know the name of his twin.
There was nothing about Iris having a sister in the files I checked.
Well, Iris was taken in by the temple when she was really young. Apparently her sister was raised by her father. A jeweler, I think.
A jeweler? Right, I might just know who this twin sister of hers is.
I had a feeling you'd say that. Let me guess. Her name is Dahlia Hawthorne, right?
Yes, exactly.
Please tell me what you know about her, Edgerith. Please.
Right, let's finally wrap all this together. It was my first court case 6 years ago. I was a greenhorn, and due to my inexperience, the defendant died.
We're talking about Terry Falls, right?
You know about that case?
You're not the only one who noticed something about Iris and Dahlia Hawthorne. I checked one of Mia's old files from 6 years ago.
Yes, Dahlia was a key witness in that case. Dahlia and Terry Falls conspired together to stage a fake kidnapping 11 years ago. They stole a jewel worth $2 million from Dahlia's father, a jeweler. And 5 years after that, she murdered her own sister, Valerie Hawthorne, to keep her from talking. Maybe that's a stepsister of some kind, perhaps.
Her sister?
Well, her stepsister, actually. Yes, of course. They weren't blood related. Valerie was the only daughter of Dahlia's father's second wife.
Oh, this is when she entered my life. The woman who tried to kill me. So after Terry Falls died, what happened to Dahlia? Did you check that out?
There is no need. Like I said, Dahlia isn't connected with this case.
Why are you so sure about that?
It's simple. Dahlia Hawthorne is dead.
Really? Was she executed for murder?
What?
Well, her metabolic processes are a matter of interest only to historians, so to speak.
How did she die?
What do you mean by Dahlia Hawthorne is dead, Edgerith?
I only just discovered this right. But I never knew about the murder case you were involved in during your college years. Dahlia Hawthorne was found guilty. Thanks to the persistence of Mia Fey. Mia Fey! Mia Fey!
Oh dear. The time, Dahlia. It's like she was possessed by a demon or something.
It's been 6 years since that guilty verdict was handed down. And her sentence was finally carried out.
She was executed last month.
Executed?
I'm sure that's a bit of a shock for you, right? And for more reasons than one. But do you understand now? She can't possibly be connected with this case.
So there we go, that's definitely proof that this, that even in the westernized version, execution is the penalty for murder.
She's dead. And once someone is dead, there is no way to revive them.
Oh, there's no way to revive the dead. Oh no, it's... I'm not sure how I feel about this. If it handles this sensibly, I'm okay with it. But if it's just starting to revive people willy-nilly, then I'd be turned off about the supernatural element, to be honest. Because I've loved how these cases, while they've been wacky, they've been grounded in somewhat realism.
I wonder. Seems you're not aware of one other connection yet, Edgeworth.
And what is that?
It's about Iris and Dahlia Hawthorne's mother.
What's their mother got to do with any of this?
She's Morgan Fay, a spirit medium from a branch family of the Corain Channeling Technique.
Did you say Corain Channeling Technique?
Do you know something about it?
Oh yes, I know it's connected with that fraudulent spirit medium.
Fraudulent?
I was involved in another nightmare 17 years ago. I was caught up in the middle of a murder investigation. The police didn't have any leads. They were stumped. That's when they called her in. She was a very famous spirit medium and the master of her channeling school. But you know what happened? As a result of her efforts, an innocent man was accused of murder. She and her powers, they were all fraudulent.
Edgeworth.
Go to the police records room. It's all in there. All you have to do is check the DL6 incident case files and you'll know.
Of course. Can I forget? Edgeworth was a victim in that case.
No, he's not got a fan of spirit. He's not a fan of spirit mediums then.
Edgeworth, you'll understand someday. And then you'll see that the Corain Channeling Technique is real.
Right, okay, so what did we get out of that then? Dali is dead. I think it will have updated this, wouldn't it? Dahlia Hawthorne. Well, that's a good way to reskin a character. Was she executed, though? Right, okay. So now can I go to Pearls and unlock that, or is it... Maybe it's not Pearls, maybe it's... if I go back to where Bikini was, maybe she has monsters that I'm looking for. So let me just try and give that another go.